we're back. We're ready for this year. We feel good about the off-season work we've done, and you know, the better you train, the better chance you put yourself in position to reduce or lessen the risk of injury. So we feel good about that. We've worked the same this year as we've worked every year. I just think there's great senior leadership, good buy-in, very, very loyal. We've just had excellent off-season workouts for kids that were not out for sports during the school year, which we want kids playing multiple sports first and foremost, but if they're not, we had really good workouts, very good spring practice, very good Gold Beach, and we've had great summer workouts, and just kids are really committed.
How do you feel this team stacks up right now as the one you had 2 years ago that won the state championship?
Very similar. You know, great senior class, and those, of course, the seniors this year were sophomores then, and they were an integral part of that, but great senior leadership and a great senior class, just performance-wise. Very, very good depth, especially in the line. We feel like we can run the ball well and with the play-action package to go with it, and then feel like we're very, very active on defense and very sound on special teams, so a lot of similarities. We want all seniors to have their best year as a leader and a player. They're the most experienced, should be the most bought in, sold out, and so we want all of them to be great leaders, but Braden, Mike Klug, AJ McCullough and Bryson Sullivan have been, you know, mainstays on the line as players and leaders. And Thomas Tyner has really taken on a bigger role this spring and summer. And he's always been such a quiet, humble kid. He's really taken on a bigger role. CJ's done a good job from the quarterback spot. So we expect the whole senior class, but those guys have been really instrumental in their, you know, by positions. Those guys have done a great job of leadership. Jason Ritchie's another guy. We talked about kind of the unsung guys. Jason Ritchie's a kid that plays defensive end, tight end, that really had a good spring, and he was on the All-Star. He was selected the All-Star team at the Gold Beach camp. Isaac Bumalag is a kid, outside linebacker, running back, who really came on at the end of the season. And then our linebacker crew, just as an overall group, we feel very, very good about. Well, Maurice McSwain's very, very talented wide receiver DB that's a junior. A lot of unsung heroes always on the line. And again, the line, we have great, we think, depth, size, and experience. Maybe the best year we've had since I've been there, but a lot of line guys, probably too many to name. So Maurice, for sure, would be a guy that's not been on everybody's radar screen, but I think is going to have a great year for us on both sides of the ball.
Is there any incentive for you, your last year here at Aloha High School, to go out on top? Have you thought about that at all?
Oh, I've thought about it, but I don't. I've never said a word to the kids about it. I don't want to say, hey, we want you to do something special for me, being my last year. That's not the way I operate. So we just treat it like every other year. Obviously, it's in the back of your mind. Our goal is to be practicing on Thanksgiving Day, and we kind of reevaluate everything from there. And that's the same exact goal. Everything's been treated the same. Everything's went along the same kind of calendar as normal, and so I'm just treating it like a normal year.
Does it feel like a normal year?
Yeah, it really does. My whole focus and attention is here, and the George Fox thing is going to be a great thing in the future, but my whole focus, intention, energy is here.